I was born with the curiosity to explore the realms of darkness, to seek out the elusive shadows and question their existence, their never-ending convolution with the light. All things were born from this darkness. Everything. Find your own truth, engage all mysteries, open your mind, and join me on my journey through the darkness. It was a normal Wednesday night, and I was returning home from my weekly stop at the local library. At the time, I had no license and wasn't able to drive, so I was a regular at the bus terminal and knew almost everyone who rode the same route. Tonight was an exception. There was a boy, possibly 15 or 16, sitting alone in the back of the bus. The light above him flickered on and off. The scene was quite surreal, as all the other lights were working fine. He kept his head down, but there was a strange draw to him that I found curious. Although excited about my new book, I kept peering up at the lad, unable to focus on the story. So I put it away with the intention of returning to it once I got home. I kept thinking to myself, maybe it's the flickering lights that keeps drawing my attention. I was relieved when the bus came to a halt at my stop. Getting out of the bus, I took one last glance at the boy, and for the first time the entire trip, he looked up at me. Something about him gave me chills. I quickly muttered my thanks to the driver, as I had always done, and hurried out of the bus. It was a little after 10 at night, and I had a few blocks to walk before I got to my house. Living in a bad part of town, I sat in the bus stop, the ones with the plexiglass walls, tied my unlaced shoe, and removed the pocket knife from my sock. As I was coming back up, knife in hand, I realized there was someone approaching the bus stop. Before I even saw the person, I was overcome with panic and uneasiness. And not just the paranoia of a random stranger that could be potentially dangerous, but more so the overwhelming dread of a feeling worse than death. I was frozen with fear, and for reasons unknown, I knew that it was the boy from the bus without even looking in his direction. I was angered by his invasiveness and the feeling of dread that he bestowed upon me. I gathered the courage to provoke him. "What do you want?" I raised the knife in an elevated state of defense and was surprised both by my newfound courage and my aggressive intent to attack this boy without reservation. But my fight response quickly turned into flight as I locked gaze with him and was stunned by his entirely black eyes. The sclera and all, shiny, black, and full of emptiness. There's a feeling that overcomes you when in the presence of this thing. An immediate sense that, although appearing like that of a human, this thing was something very dangerous and not of this world. I wanted to turn and run as fast as I could, but I was frozen. It was as if time no longer existed. "I think I'm lost," he said in an eerily monotonous voice. I turned and ran as fast as I could, unsettling uneasiness and despair inspiring every stride I took. His voice repeating over and over in my head, as if he was whispering inside of my brain. My humble apartment never looked so inviting. As I reached the landing, I looked back to make sure the boy was not following me. I saw no one. The elevator ride up to the fifth floor, even with the happy music playing from the speaker above me, held no reassurance and no comfort. Everything seemed eerie to me. The yellow-orange lights within the elevator made my skin appear a sickly shade that I had never noticed in the 12 years I had lived there. Even the ding of the elevator reaching my floor startled me. I took a deep breath and tried to calm myself. The flight response was still with me, and I had the shakes to prove it. I pulled out my keys and turned the corner of the hallway toward my door, and was horrified by what sat at my doorstep. It was the boy. How had he gotten there so quickly? There was only one elevator, and taking the stairs would have been a much longer trek. I halted in place and stared in disbelief. "Can I come in? I need help. Can I use your phone?" His words carried underlining meaning that was far less innocent. I stayed with a friend for the next 2 weeks until I got a new place and hired movers to deliver my belongings to the new apartment. I never stepped foot in that building or the bus again.